அன்பார்ந்த மாணவர்களே, இந்த வீடியோவில் 12ஆம் வகுப்பு கெமிஸ்ட்ரி யூனிட் 11 ஹைட்ராக்சி காம்பவுண்ட்ஸ் அண்ட் ஈதேஸ் என்ற பாடத்தில் இன்ட்ரொடக்ஷன் ஆஃப் ஈதேஸ், கிளாசிஃபிகேஷன் ஆஃப் ஈதேஸ் அண்ட் நோமன்கிளேச்சர் ஆஃப் ஈதேஸ் போன்ற பகுதிகளை பார்க்க உள்ளோம். First about ethers. Ethers are a class of organic compound in which an oxygen atom is connected to two alkyl or aryl groups. General representation of ether is ROR. This R may be alkyl group or aryl group. Ethers can be considered as the derivative of hydrocarbon in which one hydrogen atom is replaced by an alkoxy or aryloxy group. Alkoxy we can represent OR, aryloxy we can represent OAR. The general formula of aliphatic ether is CnH2n+2O. So alcohol and ethers have same general molecular formula. That means alcohol and ethers are generally isomers. That is functional isomers. Okay. Then about the classification of ethers. Ethers are broadly classified into simple ether and mixed ether. Okay. Ether general representation ROR. The two alkyl groups. If the two alkyl groups or aryl groups are same, then we can say it is simple ether. If the groups are different, then we can say mixed ether. See, both simple ether, both alkyl or aryl groups attached to oxygen atom are same. Then we can say the simple ether. Two alkyl or aryl groups attached to oxygen atom are different. Okay, so this is called mixed ether. Example for simple ether is CH3OCH3. Okay, this is called dimethyl ether. IUP's name methoxymethane. Okay. Or we can say here C2H5, CH3CH2. This is also CH2CH3. There is diethyl ether or ethoxyethane. Okay, like that. Then you see this side benzene ring, this side another benzene ring. Okay, this is called phenoxybenzene. Phenoxybenzene, or we can say common name diphenyl ether. Okay, these are simple ether. Then mixed ether. You see these two alkyl groups are different. Here this methyl group. Here isopropyl group. Okay, so this compound name is, common name is methyl isopropyl ether. IUP's name 2-methoxypropane. Okay, and then here this compound, you see this side methyl group is there, this side benzene ring or phenyl group. Okay, this is this name is methyl phenyl ether or anisole, common name. Okay, methyl phenyl ether or anisole. But IUP's name is methoxybenzene. Then again, ethers are classified as aliphatic ethers and aromatic ethers. If two alkyl groups attached to oxygen of ether, then it is called aliphatic ether. You see, two alkyl groups are attached to ethereal oxygen, then it is called aliphatic ether. So these two are example for aliphatic ethers. Then aromatic ethers. Aromatic ether means if one or more alkyl group, sorry, aryl group, if one or more aryl group attached to oxygen of ether, then it is called aromatic ether. You see, any one or both of the group attached to the ethereal oxygen is aryl group. Okay, you see here, this is phenoxybenzene. Okay, two aryl groups are there. Here one alkyl group, one aryl group is there. So these two are aromatic ethers. Okay, this common name anisole. Okay, this is diphenyl ether. Then the structure of functional group. Structure of functional group. The structure of functional group. You see the structure of ethereal oxygen, which is attached to two alkyl group, is similar to the structure of hydroxyl group of alcohol. Okay. The oxygen atom is sp3 hybridized. The central oxygen atom is sp3 hybridized. Okay, two hybridized orbitals have lone pairs of electron, and the other two hybridized orbitals have unpaired or single electrons. Okay, so then the two orbitals having unpaired electron can overlap with the sp3 hybridized orbitals of carbon linearly to form sigma bonds. So this side one sigma bond, this side another sigma bond is formed. Okay, and then the bond angle. This is a tetrahedral bond angle is 109 degree 28 minutes or 109.5 degree approximately. Okay, but here two bulkier groups are there. Okay, this is one alkyl group or aryl group. This is also alkyl or aryl groups are there. So these two groups are bulkier groups. So they repel each other. They need more place to occupy, and hence bond angle is increased little bit, and bond angle is approximately 111.7. Degree. Okay, so this value is not a constant for all EDs. When the size of the alkyl group changes, this bond angle also will change slightly. Okay, the oxygen atom is sp3 hybridized. The two sp3 hybridized orbital of oxygen linearly overlap with two sp3 hybridized hybrid orbitals of carbon, which are directly attached to the oxygen forming two CO sigma bonds. The COC bond angle is slightly greater than the tetrahedral bond angle due to repulsive interaction between two bulkier alkyl groups. Now we can go to IUPAC nomenclature, IUPAC system. Okay, the let us recall the naming of EDAs according to IUPAC nomenclature. Okay, before going to that, you have to understand to certain extent the priority or seniority table, priority order or seniority table. Okay, you see various functional groups are given. Okay, they are prefix names, suffix names. Some functional groups have both the prefix name and the suffix name. Okay, then which one is more prior group, which one is least prior? Okay, that means while numbering the parent chain, the more prior group attached to a carbon should get the lowest number. Like that only we have to give the number in parent chain. Okay, so we must know the priority order. Okay, so you see this is alkyl group. Alkyl groups have least priority, then halogen, then nitro, then triple bond, then double bond. Triple bond is less priority than double bond, keep in mind. Then alkoxy. So the alkoxy groups are having more priority than the double bond and the triple bond. Keep in mind, alkoxy groups, this either alkoxy group, it is having more priority than double bond and the triple bond. Okay, then amino group, then hydroxyl group, ketone, then isocyanide, then cyanide. Okay, then aldehyde, amide, acid halide. Okay, acid halide, then sulfonic acid, this one generally it won't come to our book. Okay, then carboxyl group, this one. Then here ester. The most prior group is the carboxyl group. Most prior group is the carboxyl group. Okay, then while naming the compound, organic compound, first we have to write prefixes we have to write, then parent root word, we can say parent chain, that is root word name. Then suffix consists of two suffixes. You see, primary suffix and secondary suffix. Don't forget, primary suffix is ein, in, ein. These three only primary suffix. Okay, along with the primary suffix, one more secondary suffix will come. Okay, if the compound have functional group. Okay, the secondary suffix, you see, these are the secondary suffix: carboxyl, ester, sulfonic acid, acid halide, and so on. These are the suffix groups name. Okay, these groups, you see, from here to here, these groups have prefix name as well as suffix name. Why these two names are given? One name is suffix in Israel. Then why they given the two names? The reason is that the suffix name, only one compound, only one functional group name we can write as suffix name. If the compound have two functional groups or three functional groups, then the more prior group we can take as the suffix name. The remaining groups we have to write as prefix names only. Okay, for example, if the compound have hydroxyl group, OH group, and COOH, COOH is the more prior group. So the compound ends with the oic acid. So for the alcohol, OLAL, it is not possible to write. In such a case, we have to use hydroxy. Okay, so you keep in mind, you have to mark up this order. Or not only this order, prefix names, suffix names also. You have to mark up, because in different places, we have to apply this table. Okay, now, let us go to the name. Before that, already you see in alcohol, I explained about the alkyl group names. Alkyl group names are already given. Okay, then one more thing you keep in mind, C6H5, prefix name is phenyl and suffix name is benzene. That also keep in mind, C6H5, prefix name is phenyl, suffix name is benzene. Similarly, C6H5CH2, prefix name is benzyl. C6H5CH2, prefix name is benzyl. Okay, suffix name is methyl benzene. Okay, these two names also you keep in mind. Now let us go to the nomenclature. Common name and IUPAC name. Common name, how to write? Alkyl ether is the common name. If two same kinds of alkyl groups are there, then we can say dialkyl ether. If two different alkyl groups are there, we can say alkyl ether. Then which alkyl group we can write first and which alkyl group we can write second? Alphabetically, we have to arrange. Okay. Alphabetically, we have to arrange. You see, for example, this is two methyl groups are there, similar groups. So dimethyl ether. Okay. But here you see, this is methyl group, this is isopropyl group. Common name, only common name now you are seeing. This is methyl, this is isopropyl. Okay. So which one will come first? This isopropyl, I, don't take this I. Okay. We have to see which one. Propyl only, we have to see. The prefix names are, we have to, don't consider the prefix, which one, the prefixes like iso, neo, tertiary, and so on. Okay. So here you see, this is P, propyl. This is methyl. Okay. So first we can write methyl isopropyl ether. This compound is methyl isopropyl ether. Okay. Here you see, this is methyl, this is tertiary butyl. Okay. Which one will come first? This is butyl, B. So first we can write this one. Don't see this T. Okay. We have to see that B only. Okay. So tertiary butyl, this one we have to write first. Tertiary butyl methyl ether. Okay. Then this one you see. Here methyl phenyl. Two groups are there. Phenyl, methyl. Which one we have to write first? Methyl. So this is methyl phenyl ether. It have another one commercial name. Also common name we can say it is anisol. One more name, anisol. These are common names only. Okay. Then you see, this is a phenyl group. This is ethyl group. Okay. How to name it is ethyl phenyl ether. Ethyl phenyl ether. Then another name is phenatol. So you see, benzene ring C6H5O. Then CH3 comes. Then it is called anisol. C2H5, then called phenatol. Okay. Then you see two phenyl rings. Phenyl, benzene group, benzene ring. Illa. So this name is diphenyl ether or phenyl ether. Simply we can say phenyl ether. Diphenyl ether or phenyl ether. And then you see this is a benzene ring. Here CH2 six times. CH3. That means six carbon here one seven carbon. So heptane. Okay. So this name is, this is N-heptyl, long chain, okay, no branches. N-heptyl, phenyl ether, N-heptyl, phenyl ether, okay. Then this one, how to give the name, you see, this is benzene ring, this one is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 5 carbon. So iso, one second carbon, you see, methyl group is there, so called iso. Isopentyl. Phenyl ether. You see, both the group have first letter P only. Isopentyl P, first letter. Here phenyl P. the second, in such a case we have to see the secondary letter here, E, here H. E comes first this side, so isopentyl phenyl ether. This is the common name. Okay, then this compound you see. See here two methyl groups are there. If here H instead of this methyl group, it is H, and here also H, then we can say it is glycol. In glycol, instead to hydrogen atom, two methyl groups are there. So this compound is called dimethyl glycolate. Okay, these are common names. Okay, now let us go to the IUPAC name. How to give the IUPAC name? IUPAC name is alkoxy alkane. Now here the question is, which here you see in either two alkyl groups are there, alkyl aryl groups are there. The IUPAC name is alkoxy alkane. So which alkyl group we can take as alkoxy, and which alkyl group we can take alkane? Okay, you see here the in this case you see smaller alkyl group we have to take alkoxy, and larger one we can take as alkane. The smaller alkyl group we can take as alkoxy, and larger alkyl group we can take as alkane. Okay, here it is, you see it is simple either. Okay, both side the same, so we can say methoxy, CH through methoxy, methane. The second alkyl group we can take as alkane. Okay, keep in mind. So methoxy, methane. Now here you see this is smaller group, this is larger group. The smaller group oxy we can take. Okay, so methoxy propane, but here number system is required. Propane, which carbon the oxygen is attached? See, 1, 2, 3 second carbon. Okay, so we can say the name is 2-methoxy propane. Okay, no gaps here, you see. Okay, single word only. This one you see, this is methyl, this is smaller one, this is larger one. So this oxy only, methoxy. How to name the this compound? You see number we can give here 1, 2, 3, or we can say here 1, 2, 3. Anyway, we can take, no problem. Okay, then you see second carbon methyl is there. Okay, so we can give the name 2-methoxy 2-methyl propane. This is first one, we can say this one 2-methoxy. This is methoxy, this is adipose number 2. So 2-methoxy 2-methyl propane. Okay, then this compound you see here, this is smaller one, this is larger one. Okay, so we can say this is methoxy benzene. C6H5, suffix name benzene, prefix name phenyl, don't forget. Then this compound you see here, ethyl is there, here a benzene ring is there. Okay, then how to name it? Here the ethyl group is smaller. Okay, so ethoxy benzene. Okay, ethoxy benzene. You see the alkyl group have up to 5 carbon atom, no problem. If 6 carbon atom, sorry, up to 6 carbon atom, no problem. The smaller alkyl group, that means the alkyl group we can write the first name, then which one? The benzene ring name. Okay, if the alkyl group have 7 or 8 and so on carbon atom, then the alkyl group name will comes second. Okay, the aryl group name comes first in such cases. Okay, then you see here phenyl benzene ring, both are benzene ring only, that is phenyl groups. Okay, so this name is phenoxy benzene. Here you see 7 carbon is there. Okay, here 7 carbon is there, 7 carbon. So this is the smaller one, smaller, this is larger. Okay, so this name is 1-phenoxy at one end only. This O is attached at one end of this linear chain. Okay, so 1-phenoxy heptane. Okay, then this compound you see 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 5 carbon is there. Okay, so here 6 is there. So this is prefix name, this is suffix name. Okay, so how to say 1, 2, 3? This carbon get this lowest number because this oxygen is there. Okay, so 1, 2, 3, 4. At the position number 3, methyl is there. So 3 methyl, keep in mind 3 methyl here 1, 2, 3, 4 carbon. Okay, at position number you see at position number 1 oxy is there. Okay, so we can say 3-methyl, this is 3-methyl, 1-butoxy, 1-butoxy benzene, benzene. Okay, then this compound, how to give the name? Here two carbons are there, only two carbon. Okay, here one methoxy, here one methoxy. Okay, so 1, 2 dimethoxy ethane. Okay, 1, 2 dimethoxy ethane. This is the IUPAC name. Okay,
now let us see, evaluate yourself. Give the IUPAC name for the following ethers and classify them as simple or mixed. You see, the first compound, the two sides of oxygen atom, you see, the groups are different, is right? So it is mixed ether. Here also, same way, it is mixed ether. Here also, you see this oxygen, these two side groups are different. So it is mixed ether. But this oxygen, you see, both the sides, the groups are same. So this is simple ether. Here you see, here also, both sides, it is not same, different, okay? So it is mixed ether. Here, dibenzyl ether. So two benzyl groups, one side one benzyl group, another side another benzyl group. So it is simple ether. Vinyl allyl ether. Here one side vinyl group is there, another side allyl group is there. So it is mixed ether. Okay. So simple ether is here 4 and 6. These two compounds are simple ethers. All others are mixed ether. Now let us see the IUPAC nomenclature. For the first compound, you see here this is the smaller alkyl group. So this is this one oxy we have to take. This one is larger here. Four carbon atoms are there in a straight chain. Okay, so oxygen is at carbon number 1, position number 1. Straight. So the name is 1-ethoxy-butane. Okay, 1-ethoxy-butane. Then this compound, you see, this is methoxy, this is chloro. Already we studied that the alkoxy group is more prior than chloro. Okay, so this is position number 1, this is 2, 3, this is 4. So the name is 4-chloro-1-methoxybenzene. 4-chloro-1-methoxybenzene. Okay, then question number 3. You see, this is ethoxy. This carbon is, this is the more prior group. Okay, it is position number 1. 2, 3 methyl is there. So 1-ethoxy-3-methyl-benzene. Then what about this compound name? This one we can draw the correct structure. You see like this, tertiary butyl this side. This side also tertiary butyl group. Okay. So see here one tertiary butyl group is suffix, another is prefix. Let's just say this is suffix. So this is carbon number 1, 2, 3. 2 at position number 2 methyl is there. So 2-methyl-propane. 2-methyl-propane. Suffix name. Prefix name you see. 2-methyl. Okay. Then methoxy. Methoxy is at position number 2. So you see 2-methyl. And this is propoxy. Okay. 2-methyl then propoxy. So 2-methyl-2-propoxy. 2-methyl-propane. This is the name of this compound. Okay, and then fifth one, methoxy. This is more prior group. This group is attached to position number 1. This carbon, this is the lowest number. We have to give lowest number. So this is 1, this is 2, this is 3. Okay, so the name is 1-methoxy-1-chloro. You see 3 carbon. So prop at position number 2, double bond is there. So 2-ene. So 1-methoxy-1-chloro-prop-2-ene. Okay. Then dibenzyl ether. The structure we can draw like this: benzyl C6H5CH2O. Then again CH2C6H5. Okay. The suffix name is methylbenzene. Suffix name. Prefix you see. If C6H5 only is there, we can say it is phenyl. Again CH2 is there, so we can say it is benzyl. So this compound name is benzyl oxy. Benzyl oxy. Methylbenzene. Benzyl oxy, methyl benzene. Then next compound you see, vinyl allyl ether. Vinyl is CH2CH, single bond vinyl. Allyl is CH2, double bond CH, single bond CH2, single bond. So vinyl allyl is this structure. This is the vinyl allyl either. Okay. And the here smaller group is this one. This is the smaller group. This is larger group. So this group oxy we have to take. Okay. This is ethene. So ethene oxy. Ethene oxy. Ethene. Last E is dropped. Okay. So ethene oxy. Okay. Then it is at position number where? One. Okay. So one ethene oxy. Here three carbon. So at position number two, double bond is there. So two ene. One ethene oxy, group two ene. Okay. Then preparation of this we can study in the next video. Thank you.
அன்பார்ந்த மாணவர்களே, இந்த வீடியோ உங்களுக்கு பிடித்திருந்தால் சப்ஸ்கிரைப் செய்யுங்கள், லைக் செய்யுங்கள், ஷேர் செய்யுங்கள். திரையில் தோன்றும் லிங்கை பயன்படுத்தி பிளஸ் டூ கெமிஸ்ட்ரியில் உள்ள வீடியோக்கள் அனைத்தையும் பார்வையிடலாம். நன்றி.